Hey there, everybody. This is Aaron from Gigatitan, and this is another Pokemon Wi-Fi battle. And so here we go. This is another 3-on-3 singles match over random Wi-Fi. And let's go ahead and get into it. So start out with Caracosta, as I did last time. Go for a Shell Smash, and I haven't seen a Lopunny on Wi-Fi in, I think, ever in 5th generation. So I forgot about Circle Throw and forgot that she could learn it. So, or I guess in this case, he. So I waste my Shell Smash, and I take a lot of damage because I lost half of, you know, my defense was halved. So basically they just did a ton of damage to me and just got it for free. And so it was just all bad. So gonna go back to Caracosta again, and they use Thunder Wave on me, so I'm pretty much gonna be locked down and I'm just pretty much gonna just be paralyzed. I go for a Stone Edge though. I'm trying to do as much damage as I can to this thing. And I don't quite knock it out, but I chunk it off quite a bit. I take the Circle Throw pretty well because my defenses are obviously back up. Cobalion gets switched back into again, and I'm just going to finish this thing up with close combat. I don't know if he was going to switch or something like that, but I was able to outrun that thing pretty easily because of my Choice Scarf. So I knock out their Lopunny, and now Cobalion is, you know, his defenses are lowered, so I'm going to probably need to switch him out as soon as I can. So I switch out to Rotom, who I was predicting some sort of ground attack because Cobalion's weak to ground type moves, so able to avoid it with Levitate. Nidoking is switched out. They switch into a Druddigon, so I'm just gonna go for the Will-O-Wisp because I just want to eliminate that thing's physical attack. Now its physical attack is halved, so he's not be that much of a threat to me, so I should be able to knock him down. Goes for a Thunder Punch, not gonna do very much damage because his attack is halved. And I go for Hidden Power. I thought it was Ice for some reason. It's been so long, and I thought it was Ice. I think it's Grass or something like that. And I totally screw that up. So now I don't do that much. I don't think it's Grass. It might have been something else. I don't remember. Didn't do very much damage in any case. So I'm going to have to switch him out. Send in Rotom again. Goes for a Fire Punch. Not going to do much damage because I'm part Fire type. And because his attack is halved. Going to heal up with Leftovers. Only lost 10 HP out of that attack. And so I'm going to finish it off with a Thunderbolt here. Gets a critical hit with Sucker Punch, though, and that took half of my HP, and I was really unlucky, and it's just, that really sucked, because I wanted to take that thing out without taking too much damage. Rotom's now at half HP, and he's going to send back in his Nidoking, and I'm not sure what this thing's going to do to me, so I will Wisp it, because I want to make sure if he has any physical attacks, he's not going to be able to use them. He's going to use Sludge Wave, which is a special attack, and it's going to do quite a bit of damage. Almost going to knock Rotom out. He's nearly dead. But I do have Pain Split, so, and he's burned, so I use Pain Split right here, which is going to give me a lot of HP, and it's going to lower his quite a bit, so I'm going to be able to take one more hit from him. Surprised he didn't go for another Sludge Wave, but I was going to switch to Cobalion. He's probably over-predicted right there. Which, if I had, would have, you know, done no damage because I'm immune to it, to poison-type attacks. So I go for the Overheat, I finish off Nidoking, and pretty much that's the end of the battle. It was a good short battle, but thanks guys for watching, and I will see you next time with more Pokemon.